armor of God. It's all found for us in the book of Ephesians, chapter 6. Now, one of the interesting things that we find in this particular section of God's Word is that the armor referred to here is not really the armor that one individual soldier wears. No, we find in the Word of God that this armor of God is the armor that all of us as fellow believers wear to help us to fight against our common enemies of sin and the devil. Now, when it comes to wearing the armor of God, we're talking here about some of the spiritual things that we, as the family of believers of God in His church, all wear together. So today I want to start by talking with you about the armor that's right at the top of our body, the armor of the helmet of salvation. In the state of Louisiana, many people are upset because they came up with this law that said that all motorcycle riders and bicycle riders had to wear a helmet. Now, the reason the motorcycle and bicycle riders were upset was they didn't want anyone telling them what they had to do. But the lawmakers cared a lot more about safety than they did here about freedom. And if you've ever seen anyone who's been in a motorcycle or a bicycle accident, you know how serious those accidents can be. You know that oftentimes the very first part of the body that gets injured is the head. And some of those injuries to the head are long-lasting and cause severe damage. And that's why Louisiana has this law. Well, God tells us in His Word today that He wants us to wear the helmet of salvation. Why? He says to wear the helmet of salvation so it will protect you in your own Christian life. Here in the Word of God before us today, the Apostle Paul compares our salvation in heaven to this soldier's helmet. Years ago, a soldier always wore a helmet to protect his head. Soldiers still today wear helmets. The helmet protects all the soldiers together as they're fighting against a common enemy. The helmet would also protect the most important organ in the body, which is the brain. And without a helmet, the enemy could easily hit the soldier's head and kill him. So you can see the helmet was a very important piece of armor. Well, in our Christian lives on this earth, it's the helmet of salvation that gives us protection. The helmet of salvation protects us against the devil, who's always trying to get us to doubt that we really are going to go to heaven. The devil will say things to you like, there's nothing after life here on this earth. You simply die, and that's it. The devil will say things to you like, there's no heaven or hell to go to when you leave this earth. God just made that up to scare you into believing in Him. The devil will say to you, just enjoy all you can get out of your life on this earth. Never worry about what the end will be like. Well, it's the helmet of salvation that gives to you and me here today the confidence that we're going to be with Jesus in heaven through our faith in Him, no matter what may come here on this earth. The helmet of salvation helps us to fight against the devil's deceptive temptations. The helmet of salvation gives us that certainty of knowing that when we leave this earth, we're going to be with our Lord Jesus forever in heaven. Salvation in heaven, it's a certainty, because Jesus died on that cross and rose from the dead for us. When Jesus died and rose, He overcame all of our sins, forgiving every one of them. He overcame death for us so we never have to be afraid. He gave us the certainty of knowing we're going to be with Him forever in heaven. And so now, through our faith and trust in Jesus, we have this great certainty of going to heaven. Jesus says to us in the Gospel of John, chapter 11, verse 25, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even though he dies, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. You see, through wearing this helmet of salvation, we always have the confidence and the certainty of knowing that when we leave this earth, we're going to be with Jesus forever in heaven. Wow, that's great news. That's some of the best news that you can ever find here on this earth. Now, because of sin in this world, our lives on this earth, they're not going to be easy, are they? I mean, we would hope that once we became a Christian that everything in our lives would be perfect, but that's just not the way it is it? The devil uses all of the problems and the troubles that we face in this world to discourage us, to try to get us to turn against Jesus. The devil, he keeps reminding us of failures in our lives. He keeps bringing up those nagging problems and troubles. He keeps giving us the fear of our health or the fear of our finances. The devil, he's going to try to get us to doubt that there really is a better life after we leave this life here on this earth. You see, it's doubt that always sees the obstacles, while it's faith in Jesus that always sees the way out. It's doubt that always sees the darkest night, but it's faith in Jesus who always sees the brightest day. Doubt always gets us to dread what's coming, where faith in Jesus allows us to soar ahead. Doubt always asks, who believes in Jesus? While faith in Jesus boldly says, I believe in Jesus. God tells us in the book of Romans, chapter 8, verse 37, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through Jesus who loved us. For neither death nor life, nor angels nor demons, nor the present nor the future, nor any powers, nor height nor depth, nor anything in all creation is going to be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. There's an old story about three evil angels who were trying to come up with a plan to get more people to be in hell. The first evil angel said, let's tell them that there's no God. The other two angels said, that's not going to work because many people have seen the evidence of God in their lives on earth. The second angel said, well, let's then tell them that there's no hell. The other two angels said, no, that's not going to work because many people have seen evidences of hell in their lives on this earth. So the third evil angel said, well, let's tell them that there's no hurry. They have plenty of time to believe in Jesus. The other angels thought about that and they realized that was the best plan of all. The devil wants us to believe that there's plenty of time before we ever need to worry about believing and trusting in Jesus. The devil says there's plenty of time before we ever need to put Jesus first in our lives. There's plenty of time before we ever need to start worshiping our God. There's plenty of time before we ever need to start reading our Bibles. There's plenty of time before we need to start using our time and our talents to serve God. There's plenty of time when we get older to give back to God any of the money He's given to us. But none of us knows. None of us knows when we're going to leave this earth. And that's why it's so important we put our faith and trust in Jesus right now. That's why it's so important today that we put on the helmet of salvation right now. Because this helmet of salvation can really help you as you're living in this confusing world. As you believe in Jesus yourself, you're going to be better equipped to be able to lead others to believe in Jesus too. That's why right now is the time to use your time and your talents and your treasures to help people to see the importance of putting Jesus first in their lives. A man came to his pastor one day and said, "Pastor, I've lost my job. I've lost my money. I've lost everything." The pastor said to him, I'm very sorry to hear that. But have you lost your faith in God?" The man said, "No, I haven't lost my faith in God." And the pastor said, "Well, have you lost your good character?" The man says, "No, I still have my good character, my morals and values." And the pastor said, "Well, have you lost your salvation in heaven?" And the man said, "No, I haven't lost my salvation in heaven." And the pastor said, "Well, it seems to me then that you haven't lost all the things that are really important." Our faith and trust in Jesus gets us through anything that can come our way on this earth. Remember that when there are things on this earth that tear you down. Remember that when your life gets really stressful. Remember that when your job becomes more of a chore than a joy. Remember that when your family problems seem overwhelming to you. Remember that when your friends fail you. Remember that when your health starts to fall. Put on the helmet of salvation today. And as you walk here out of God's church, feel that confidence and that certainty that no matter what happens out in the world, you're going to be going to heaven. And when you wake up tomorrow morning, take that helmet of salvation again with you. We're all in this world together. And wearing that helmet of salvation makes us all stronger as we fight daily those great enemies of sin and death and the devil. Come back next week to hear about another piece of armor that God gives us to protect us as we live our lives here on this earth. And until then, may God bless each of you wearing your helmet of salvation. Amen.